Mike Binder here. I'm going to show you how to play Perfect Illusion by Lady Gaga. So the first thing you're going to want to do is place a capo on the second fret. And I'm going to run you through the whole arrangement. And then after we get through the arrangement, I'll show you the melody that I was doing. So to start out, we're going to play the intro. And we're going to do an E minor chord, a D chord, a C chord, and then a D chord again. And the way the rhythm goes is you go one, two, three, and. So right on the and of three, you switch. So it's one, two, three, and four. One, two, three, and four. So that's kind of the feel of the whole song. And if you're not familiar with these chords, this E minor, you're just gonna take your middle finger, place it on the A string, second fret, and your ring finger on the D string, second fret. And then D is index finger on the G string, second fret. Your middle finger on the high E string, second fret, and your ring finger on the B string, third fret. Make sure with D, you strum from the D string down. And for more of you advanced players, if your hand's big enough, go ahead and press down with your thumb on the low E string, second fret. That's a little bit more accurate to what's in the song. So every time you play a D, throw the F sharp in there, and that will be a D over F sharp. Okay, so back to the intro with the strum pattern. It goes one, two, three, and four. And then the next one will go to a C chord. So index finger on the B string, first fret, middle finger on the D string, second fret, and ring finger on the A string, third fret. Okay, so from the top, one, two, three, and four. 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 Okay, so we're just bouncing between E minor, D over F sharp, C, D over F sharp. We do that four times for the intro, and then we start the verse. Now, when we get into the verse, we're gonna play the actual strum pattern, which is down, down, rest, up, down, up. Down, down, rest, up, down, up. And the rest, you just kind of, I go by the strings and I tap. You could just kind of do a ghost note and just, you know, do a strum, but don't connect with the strings. So it's basically three down. So it's down, down, down. And the third down, you don't connect with the strings. So again, it's down, 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 up, down, up, down, down, rest, up, down, up, down, down, skip, up, down, up. Okay, however you want to think about it. Now the trick here, because we're going to keep that same crazy pattern where we switch on the and of three. So what you do is you have those three downs and the third one's a skip. So right after that third down, you're going to switch to the next chord. So you'll go down, down, skip, up, down, 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 skip, up, down. Catching that? So three total downs, one, two, skip, and then you'll go to the next chord and go up, down, up. Then we go to C, down, down, skip, up, down. So it would be down, down, skip, up, down, up, back to the D. Okay? It's the same chord progression for the verse as the intro. The E minor, D over F sharp, the C, over F sharp, but we're introducing this strum pattern, and it goes down, down, skip, up, down, up, down, down, skip, up, down, up. Okay, and that is the same progression for the chorus. So once you've learned that, you've learned the intro, the verse, and all the choruses, and it's gonna go through that verse chorus progression twice. So the whole arrangement goes intro, verse, chorus, and then verse, chorus again. And then we're going to play the bridge. Now the bridge kind of changes up a little bit. Strum pattern changes and there's a couple new chords. So what you're going to do is you're going to go to an E minor and the strum pattern is going to go down, down, up, up, down. Okay? Down, down, up, up. And then the next chord we're going to play is it's a C chord up 2 frets. So the C shape that we played earlier, we go up 2 frets. And you get this kind of crazy D sound. So you could just play a D, but I kind of like this dreamy sounding D because it's going to kind of fit into this progression that we're doing here where we kind of, we drop down. So you have your E minor, and then we're going to play a D up 2 frets using the C shape. Okay, so what I'm on the 5th fret counting from the capo. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you put your ring finger on the A string, 5th fret, your middle finger on the D string, 4th fret, and your index finger on the B string, 3rd fret. You get this really dreamy D. Okay, so you have an E minor, down, down, up, up, down, D, down, up, up, down, and then you're just gonna slide that shape down 1 fret. Leave your ring finger there, take all the fingers off except for your index, and place your index on the D string 2nd fret. Now this is like a C sharp half diminished chord. It's a pretty crazy chord, not used very often. It's also known as a diminished, half diminished 7th chord. Really cool chord. So you have your E minor, down, up, up, down. Your D, down, down, up, up, down. A C sharp, half diminished. And then a C. And we'll do this progression 3 times. One more time. Now once you get to C on the 3rd time, you're gonna go to a B7. And we'll hold that for 2 bars. Now to play a B7, place your index finger on the D string 1st fret, your middle finger on the A string 2nd fret, your ring finger on the G string 2nd fret, and your pinky on the high E string 2nd fret. So you're kind of, you're skipping every other string here. If you look at my hand, you'll see it's like, so you put your index finger there and then you skip, skip, skip. So I actually find this chord, even though it's kind of hard to play, it's kind of easy to remember because of the pattern. Okay, so once you play that B7, then the whole song modulates to do a double chorus and a final outro. And what it modulates to is an F sharp minor, an E, and then a D. So you'll go. Now I'm just trying to avoid a bar chord. You could play an F sharp minor bar chord if you'd like, and then an E and a D. It's up to you. I'm gonna just show you guys how to play this F sharp minor because not a lot of people teach this kind of F sharp minor. So this is how it goes. Middle finger on the low E string, 2nd fret. Your ring finger on the D string, 2nd fret. And then your pinky on the G string, 2nd fret. You kind of want to make sure your A string is muted by just kind of having a bad arch in your finger. So that's muted. Then let everything else ring out. And we're just going back to the original strum pattern, the down, down, mute. And then you switch to the E, up, down, up, down, down, skip, up, down, up. E is a lot like E minor. Earlier, we were playing E minor. For E, just add your index finger to the G string, 1st fret. And then, so F sharp minor, E, D, E. And we had D in the earlier chord progression, so no new chords for the modulation except for the F sharp and the E. Those will be the only new chords. And you'll play that 16 times. It's a double chorus and a vamp out. That really gets you through the whole song. Okay, to play the melody of the chorus, you're gonna come up to the 7th fret counting from the capo on the high E string. You hit that 7, And then we'll go to the 8th fret on the B string, then the 7th fret of the B string. So. And then you'll go back up to the 8 of the B, 7 of the B. So far you have. And then we'll go to a 9 on the G string. Do that twice. And then the last time you'll go 7, 10 on the B string, 8 on the B string. So that last time goes. And then you'll go 8, 10, 12, 10, 8 on the B string. So the last time it goes.